vision. So for them, it is difficult to take the CBSE exam. Quite a few of can take and do take with all the flexibility given to them in the examination system also. But there are a large number of students who have been able to derive self-esteem because they could clear 10th and 12th because of NIOS flexibility. Now, along with academic programs, we have multiple category of disabilities and non-disabled equal opportunities are provided for integrated sports, skill training, medical care, and employment opportunities. You can see some of these pictures. When they do the wheelchair dance, you know, it's really soul stirring. Next, please. Now, these are some of the vocations at Amarjyoti. Each one of them has been of great benefit to the beneficiaries. Next, please. Now, in partnership with NIOS, Amarjyoti has been able to reach out to more than 30,000 persons with disabilities since 1981. I'm just talking about a few. And this pioneering concept of inclusivity has resulted in several achievements in the field of education, vocational skill, and partnership with corporates for employment. You'll be happy to know that we were the first ones to introduce children with disability in Republic Day Parade in 1995. You can see, you know, we were for 7 months fighting with different departments. Everybody would say we want to include them, but they just cannot be a part of the parade. You know, how will they cope up with the time? We came out with all kinds of solutions, and we had a trailer from Ministry of Defense, and these children are doing most vigorous Bhangra dance on a moving elevator. And after that, every year it has become, you know, a part of the parade. And here you see Arjun and Krishna. The wheelchair rath has been made in our carpentry unit, and costumes have been stitched in our cutting and tailoring unit, and they went for a tour to perform, you know, glimpses from epics in UK, USA, Canada, and everywhere, you know, they highlighted their potential of the not only academic performances, but they did many things when we took them around. Next, please. Here is Mamta, who did stenography and started working in the administrative department of our center. And later, she was employed by a lawyer in Karkaduma courts. So she now comes as a volunteer on Sundays. Next, please. And here is a glimpse of Abilympics, which I was talking about. You know, there are 47 vocations. And these competitions, like Olympics, are held every fourth year at international level. But all the year through, we have Abilympics. Now it has become a national movement in India. We started in 1981. We have it at district, state, and national level. And the team is selected to participate in international level. And India hosted the sixth international Abilympics, where Ministry of Social Justice and Ministry of HRD supported the entire event. Next, please. As a result of this, people started learning the potential of the disabled, and many people started giving them employment. And there was self-employment as well as employment by the industrialists. Here is 32-year-old Manmeet Singh, who has hearing impairment. He is very good in macrame, and he's a gold medalist, and he got a job at Amarjyoti after getting the training in weaving. And here is Manarbhai Chauhan from Surat. He got the gold medal and bronze medal, and he utilized the award money for setting up his own photography unit in Surat. Next, please. So, creating awareness about the potential helped in PPP also. We have networking with Times of India, Tech India program, Itasha Society, many corporate houses, Rotarians, Lions, you know, each one was supposed to give a job to one person, and like that we promoted employment by showing the abilities of the disabled. And today I have another very good example of Pankaj Singh, who was a student of Amar Jyoti, and he attended this course recently of Times of India, a 3 months course, and after that he was picked up by a BPO, and he's now earning 6,000 a month, and he's very happy. He's also continuing his computer education. Already come in her paper, so I'm really excited about seeing the dream come true a little later. So these are the income generation traits that we could think of. Next, please. And I think most of the suggestions have already been suggested, but I still would like to highlight a couple of them. The elementary and higher education level in collaboration with district, state authorities and NGOs. You know, we have talked of courses at government level, but there has to be a happy marriage between government and NGOs, because NGOs are really great implementers. I hope Alkaji will agree with me. And many things can be achieved when we work together. And to seek appropriate accreditation is very important. If a course is having some kind of accreditation, job is easier to get. And then to popularize vocational training programs for disadvantaged groups and persons with disability through media and other channels. I think one of the earlier speakers also said that many people are not aware of the 82 courses that are being run by NIOS. Next, please. To organize skill competitions like Abilympics jointly by the Education Department, State Industrial Development Corporation, to foster greater employment opportunities. Then awareness needs to be created about various facilities, training and job opportunities available. Skill training should be coupled with marketability as well as employability. So this, I think, has already been suggested before. Government should fund job training for persons with disabilities by establishing additional vocational training programs in as many educational institutions as possible. All the existing institutions should make sure that vocational training becomes a part of their program. Next, please. According to Gandhiji, vocational training is mandatory for self-reliance of villagers, who are a large percentage of our population. So it's time for each one of us to arise, awake, and continue working for persons with disability till we inculcate an indomitable spirit and strengthen them. Next, please. Next. Here is just a glimpse of Amar Jyoti, which is aiming to have an inclusive, barrier-free, and rights-based society. You can see disability is not inability. It is how you provide the right kind of infrastructure, the kind of training by special educators or educators who are sensitive and understand the need of children with disability, and also making a provision of their medical needs in the premises itself. So holistic approach is the answer to our problem. Next. Thank you very much.